Welcome to Tompkins Square Park.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
So I'm going to do a little intro for this ride. I'm so glad we all made it. It's going to be kind of freeform, but the real idea is let's understand more about what climate change has done, what it's going to do, and what we can do about it. And we have some interesting speakers with us today, and I want to introduce David Bergman, who's been talking to us about some of the building side stuff.
Okay. Well, it's certainly, first of all, a very interesting looking building, unusual looking building, and that's a part of the story for me, is that it is a very eco, very green design building, and yet it looks like an interesting piece of architecture at the same time. They didn't sacrifice design in order to make it green. It's one of the first LEED Platinum buildings in the city. There's a symbol on the wall. LEED is Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design. And this building in particular has quite a few interesting, from an environmental point of view, aspects going on. And one way, maybe an interesting way to organize them is thinking about what the role of architecture and eco-design is in all of these issues, in our environmental issues. And you can break it down into three areas, I think. The first would be prevention, which we were talking about a little bit with Dan in terms of 350.org and preventing some of the environmental problems from arising. Then our next step, I guess following prevention, or if prevention doesn't work entirely, would be mitigation.
Right.
And we can look at what buildings can do to help alleviate the impacts of environmental.
Like remediation?
Somewhat, yeah. Remediation would be within alleviation, but that borderlines into the third area, which would be adaptation.
Right.
Which we would be incorporating once or if we have failed in areas of prevention as well as mitigation. So in this building we have a little bit, well, at least of the first two going on, I'm not sure about the third. In some of the prevention areas, there's a very interesting high-tech HVAC, that's a heating, ventilating, and air conditioning system going on that involves radiant heating and something called chilled beams, where the air conditioning comes from cool pipes up in the ceiling rather than the usual ductwork. It has a rain screen and double layer system on part of the facade, which of course cuts down on the heat gain and the heat loss as well in the winter. And it has a green roof up at the top. And the green roof is interesting because it helps us a little with both prevention and with mitigation. I don't know how many of you are familiar with green roofs, but among the various benefits are it alleviates some of the urban heat island effect, which causes urban areas to be hotter, but it also alleviates some of the water runoff issues in that all of our paved surfaces here, all of these porous surfaces, allow no way for the water to run off, which makes flooding like we had in the storm much, much worse. A porous surface like a green roof allows much of the water in a storm to be quickly absorbed and then more slowly released over time or evaporated, so it doesn't overwhelm the storm drain system of the city. We are at a fairly higher sea level than some of the buildings that were impacted further along the shoreline. But for instance, we know we have to be looking at, especially in vulnerable areas, building buildings so that they can survive surges like these, and that may involve raising them up. I was hearing recently about a waste treatment facility out in Queens where they actually built it 4 feet higher above ground in order to anticipate some of these floods. And you know, we all know about the problems at Bellevue and NYU hospitals where they had so much of their equipment, their mechanical equipment as well as their medical equipment, in basements.
In the back of the generator.
And the fuel mostly for their generators was in the basements. And there were good logical reasons behind that from structural points of view, but it doesn't really make a heck of a lot of sense when we know that there's going to be events like these. So we have to change a lot of our thinking in how we design buildings. And this building's a pretty good example of putting some of them together.